Hi, everyone. It's Diane Evans with StampinWithDiane.com. I'm an independent Canadian Stampin' Up demonstrator here in the interior of British Columbia. So if this is one of your first times joining, I really do. I appreciate that you have found me. And if you're joining me like you do, I appreciate that. Like, you have no idea how much I appreciate you keep coming back and watching my different videos on different things that I do. So welcome to Mystery Wednesday. I'm just going to jump on right on down to my desktop here because let's get going on this. So on for the mystery challenge, and I have to tell you, I'm so impressed with Betty. She has already posted her mystery card, and it's a beautiful card in itself. I think it, to me, it was a harder one to do because it didn't have flowers in it. So the clues were Mother's Day, embossing folder, and no flowers. So I hope that you can join along in this mystery. And I am using sweet citrus. And it's quite funny. Before I actually went on live here, I had Laura show me that the trend right now is anything citrus. She showed me an embroidery book, and on the front were limes and lemons and everything else. So I think Stampin' Up's right on track. Now, this is as a bundle. It is retiring from the J to A mini catalog. So it is available in the annual catalog, but you won't be able to get it at a bundle price. So if you're excited about getting this set, make sure that you get it while it's still bundled. And then that way you can still save your 10%, because after it's gone and it comes out in the annual catalog, you won't be saving the 10%. This is an amazing set. I never realized how neat of a set this was until I started playing with it. And maybe what I'll do is at the end of this, I'll show you a couple of samples that I did for an online retreat that I was asked to join in last weekend. In any event, it has the stamp set. It's a hybrid embossing folder and dies. And I'll show you how that works. This is probably one of the easiest embossing folders and dies to line up of all of them. Yes, wasn't Betty's card just beautiful with the butterflies? And of course, they're retiring as well. All right, so let's get cracking on this card. I'm just going to move this off to the side. So I wanted to use and I wanted to do a lime. I think this shows off the best, is shown off with the limes. For some reason, the colors are just perfect with it. So I have a piece of basic white, and this is the thick, and it's the regular card size, which is 5.5 by 8.5. And I've scored it 4.25. We'll fold into the mountain because we've broken down those paper fibers. And let's go in and use our bone folder. And by folding that way, I know you're folding the opposite way of the way that you think that you should, but by folding it that way, we've got a nice even fold there. Now, I happen to have some parakeet party, and this is 3.75 by 5 inches, and I also have a piece of vellum. Now, you can see I've gone with my vellum, and I've already run it through the embossing folder. So one, I now have, and I'm not using flowers on here, so then I can actually say I've done two of the hints, because or the clues. One is embossing, and I used the regular embossing folder that goes along with this. And I just ran it through with the vellum. Now, we all know that vellum is very, very hard to attach without showing it. Now, because there's an awful lot of different images, and this is embossed and embossed on here, it could be put on with just glue dots. But I want to show you that I've gone ahead and put the adhesive sheets onto the back here. And I'm going to show you how I'm going to attach that vellum with that. When you attach these adhesive sheets, you don't get any of the showing of the glue on here as well. And also, it sticks better to the vellum than, say, glue dots, because, or glue, because it's only in certain spots that you're actually putting that. So I decided I was going to use this. Now, my online retreat, I also did the same thing. But I used a different color, completely different color. So I'm just going like this, and I'm going to line this up. If I have to, I can trim it. But ooh, we did it. Now, also, when you are using vellum with the embossing folder, you might get some creasing. You might get some it cutting out. But this works pretty good by using the embossing or the adhesive sheets. So that's just going to go kind of on there. And it's going to be kind of like pretty simple, that part. So now this is the star of the show, I think, anyways. So I've got a piece of basic white, and we are going to then stamp our lemons on there. So the two images that we're using are, we're using this one and this one. It's a two-step stamping, and it's also a photopolymer stamp set. So the colors that work so good with these lines are Granny Apple Green and Parakeet Party. I know it's just, I just think it's amazing. So, like I say, we're trending by using anything citrus, because that is the trend this year. And I guess even the clothes are starting to show with lemons and limes on them and everything else. I know some people don't like them on cards, but honestly, it really is pretty cool. So I'm just going to go ahead. Whoops. And you notice that I've got my paper piercing mat below. And I didn't get that on there quite right. So I'm hoping that this is going to stamp okay. Oh, good. So what a great lime color, right? And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use my Parakeet Party and let's do the inside of it. So I'm just going to do it from the top down. Never thought I'd use this Parakeet Party as much as I did, or I have been. And with the new color, Lemon Lime Twist, that probably would have been amazing with this as well. So this is, like I say, a two-step stamp, and I'm just going to go in and put that in on the center. Just like that. Now, don't they look great? But wait till we cut them through there. Now, this is the part of the hybrid that, honestly, it is so easy to line this up. The thing that you want to do, we're going to put this, it's cutting and embossing at the same time. So take the side that has the logo on it, and we're just going to go ahead and we're going to just lie this in here. And when you've got it in the right spot, it actually sort of clicks right in place and doesn't move around. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this, just going to put it down like that, close it, and then I'm going to come in here and line it up. Oops. Let's see, I just got to get a piece of this so that I can play with it. All right, so all you're going to do, this Band-Aid's playing havoc with me. Anyways, you're just going to take this and line up those four pieces, just like so. And then you're going to run it through on your embossing, in through your cut and emboss machine. So let's just do that. And I've actually gone ahead and I've cut those out to save some time and save the jiggling and the, everything. But look at them. And honestly, you see them in real life, they look like real limes. So I've got those. And of course, I've got some lemons in there too. And then also what you want to do on there, or on a spare piece of the basic white, and we'll just grab another one of those, is I'm going to show you how I did the leaves. So I took my Parakeet Party, and I think I put my leaves back. No, I didn't. Oh, here we go. So I just took my Parakeet Party. Whoops. And I took the Granny Apple Green. And I just took a sponge dauber. And just kind of colored around here just to give it a bit more dimension on the leaves itself. And I'm just coming in with my paper piercing mat. And there, and it's just got a bit of shading on it. It's very subtle. So we're gonna stamp two of those. And I've already done that as and cut that out as well. Oh, wow. I'm glad you caught me, Mary. All right, so I have one there. Oh, did I not cut two? I did. Okay. And I know that's an even number, but we can just do three leaves and that'll give us our uneven amount. And then what I want to do is I'm going to, because remember my last part with this clue is to make sure that it's a Mother's Day card, right? So I'm taking one of my favorite stamp sets, and that's Country. Let me grab it, my Country Bouquet. And I'm taking this stamp set, Just Wanted to Say. And then on the inside, what I'm going to do is I am putting the Happy Mother's Day on there. Now, the unfortunate part is I could only find one stamp set. You know what? This could stamp crooked. So all you want to do is you just want to lay this down and let that relax. Pick that up. And now I'm going to use the Granny Apple Green on this Just Wanted to Say. So I've got to just move this off to the side so I can see it without bumping the camera. Just like that. And then what I want to do is I want to also go and I'm not going to stamp it completely on the inside. What I'm going to do is I'm going to actually punch it out with the dual oval punch. So my Just Wanted or my Mother's Day is going to be this one here. Now it is a little scripty of a font compared to the other font I've used on the front, but you know what? It's the only one I have. And this came from the Celebrating You stamp set. This is retiring. From last I checked, it's still available to order. So we're just going to put that right there. I did that in Granny Apple Green as well. And then I'm just going to come in with my dual oval punch. And we're just going to punch out. And I have to use this. Well, no, I really don't. Could use this one. Okay, I'm going to cut this down so that we can get it in that little oval there. And then maybe what we can do is layer this. So let's just take this and line this up. We don't want that white one. I want a parakeet party, or I'm thinking maybe a granny apple green. Let's see what colors I've got in here that I could use. Well, I've got both of them. So let's see. Do I want maybe the parakeet party would be better on the inside. So I'm just going to take this and grab a oval. This. So, okay, I think we're almost ready to put this card together now. So, like I say, I've got the basic white here. I put the vellum onto this piece there. I have the Just Wanted to Say. Now, I also went and cut Hello. I'm glad you like this stamp set. There's really mixed feelings on this, but like I was saying earlier, it's very, very popular. It's in the world of fashion, even. Fashion, home decor, that sort of stuff. All right, so I do have that circle, and I want to go ahead and put some of this on there. Now, this was a piece of a card that was... You know what? I can put it like this. Now, I know that's got four on there, but by the time I end up putting all this other stuff on, it'll be okay. So You know what? I do have this baker's twine. And I'm going to use the Parakeet Party. It's one of the in colors. And you know what? This is going into the new annual catalog. So that's kind of fun. So if you have some left over, it's great, right? So let's just wrap that around a couple of times. You know what? Let's do it four times. I'm good with that. I'm just going to have this come here. And I'll take this off. Come in with my ribbon scissors and just... I was busy using up all my colors that I thought were retiring, or things that were retiring. And then I found out that, oof, this one's not retiring. So it's all good. All right. So I'm just going to go ahead and tie this in a knot to begin with. Now, if this is not tight enough, what I can do is I could go to the back and I could tighten this up on the back with tear and tape, but I think this one will be okay. So I'm just going to put that on there like that. Come in with my liquid glue. Pretty plain card, actually. It's funny, we were talking about key lime pie yesterday, and that was one of my mom's favorites. So that and lemon meringue. So that's what set me to the sweet citrus stamp set. Yes, you're right, Felicia. They are so refreshing when you have this. So I've got this circle. This is from the Stylus Shapes, and I'm actually going to put it underneath. And you know, I'm going to have lots of layering on there, so I'm going to put this right onto the card, right onto the vellum. And we're just going to hold that just for a sec. Remember, if you like this, give me the thumbs up. Share my video. I really do appreciate it when you do that. Now, let's bring in my dimensionals. You know, and I'm going to overkill this on this particular one. But I want this one sticking up. And then what we can do is I can turn around and... tuck different things underneath. And so we're going to have that go maybe a little bit underneath that baker's twine. Let's go and put the, I love this part of it. So I think I'm even going to get that going this way so we don't lose that part. And our part one there. Even this up here. Okay, so I'm just going to come and put dimensional behind this particular one. Even though I don't dimensionalize the full thing, I really like doing it on certain parts, and you'll see when I start adding the leaves how I do that as well. So let's... Probably shouldn't have put that all down on there so that I could have had some. So again, this is flat. I want to put a tiny bit there. Good morning. Myrtle, you must be from the South Pacific. I'm pretty sure that's where I've seen you come from. So this is just going to go up here. I want to put one underneath there. Let's just put, we can put that glue right on there. I know this is four. I'm going to come in here and we're just going to put this on here. But because it's, let's see, I want my little dimensionals. And of course, if I want that, I won't find them. And when I want them, or when I don't want them, I find them. So I'm just going to come here and I'm just going to put a couple on, just on the tips. And this one, we're just going to glue right down. Well, that's what was supposed to happen then, lifted. So again, I'll come in here and put, you guys, this stamp set is truly amazing. going to come on there. And then this part's just going to come down here. There we go. And then I thought this just wanted to say, could go straight across there, and we'll put a dimensional right here. Like I say, it's a pretty easy card. The hybrid embossing, I love the fact that you can do both things at once. Just going to put that on there. You know what? I should double dimensionalize that because it looks like that's up a little bit. So let me just bring this up. And when I mean double dimensionalize, I'm just going to take another dimension. I'm just going to put this right on top of that one. And then that way it's not going to dip. So I've got to bend it out. It's kind of neat when you can get the baker's twine also overlapping on this. Now, just turning this one around, I don't know if I've got enough room to tie a bow on here. But when you do bunny bows, the best way to do one and you want it to be straight is to do it upside down. And I am thinking that that's too short. Let's try it one more time and then I'll give up on it if not. So just going to tie this around. If I did it a normal way I do a bow, I would probably... Let's see if this is going to work. Nope. All right, well, we'll do it this way then. That is not staying on there. Oh, because I didn't take the dimensional off. That is why. But see how it is kind of upside down. Let's tie that tight. I just see something right now, so I think I'm going to just sort of like that. Sure not lying straight, that's for sure. All right, so I'm just going to come and cut this piece, and I see something happening on the other side, so definitely wasn't. So I'm actually going to take this and just, let's separate this, make it so it's kind of, frayed, because the other side is frayed, so we might as well make it, if I cut that other side off, it would have been so short, so. Let's just do that. There we go. You don't really notice that too much. All right, so then these dots are retiring, but I'm going to use these on here. And we're going to go ahead and use 5 on here. Whoops. I find the small ones are so small that you need to almost use 5. There we go. Whoops. There we go. And then we are going to go on the inside. And you know what? I have probably already lost my sentiment, right? My goodness, where would it have gone? So I wanted to put that on the inside. That is funny. because I went ahead and punched it. That's okay. So what we'll do is we'll pretend that we've got that on there, and I'll come in and put it after. But I want to come in with my Parakeet Party and one of my smaller ones. So I'm just going to come in and sponge this on the inside. And I'm going to quickly cut one of those Mother's Day because that was part of the deal. So let me stamp that again. So I'm going to go in with Happy Mother's Day in Granny Apple Green. Come in with that stamp. I'm going to put this down further because then that punch can go and punch that piece out. Now I don't, you know what, it's not bad to have a oval scalloped punch, so I'm going to go ahead and just punch that all out. Take my sponge. Let's just sponge around. Oh dear. Okay. Hello. Oh, I'll find it now. I know I will, Betty. That, of course, that's what's going to happen. Now, because this is going on the inside of the card, I'm not going to pop up this up at all. Otherwise, we could have some issues with mailing, that sort of stuff. And then this is just going to go right on the inside here. And of course, you know, if you wanted to, but this, like I say, the clue was a Mother's Day. Let's just put that there. So kind of lemony on or limey on the inside. Oh, look, I found it. And there we go there. We've got this frayed a little bit. So there is my mystery challenge. We have used embossing. It's a Mother's Day card. And also, it is not flowers. My sentiment is upside down. No, it's not. Oh, oh, Marie, you told me where it was. Oh, my goodness. That's good. So I just want to show you a couple of other cards that I made for this online retreat. I did do another one that has this, that was with the lime on there as well. I also did one, this has very similar with the vellum, and this is done with pale papaya. And then this one was an extra, and it was done with evening evergreen, and it had mango melody, which of course we all know that is retiring. So there you go. There's the extra cards on there. So there's my mystery challenge. I hope you like that. Now, like I say, if you like that, give me the thumbs up, share my video. I really do appreciate it. If you're on YouTube, you could share it wherever. Thank you. Yeah, they're pretty colorful, aren't they? But you can make them into blood oranges. You can make them into oranges. You can make them into clementines, limes. You could make them into grapefruit. And I've even seen them done into coconuts. So go figure that. That was when we were in Vienna, when we saw it there. All right, so we have that. Let me just jump back up here. So what's happening? If you do live in Canada and you do not have a demonstrator that you're working with, I would love to work with you. Tomorrow is my Now What series. And I do that at 6:30 Pacific time. Going to be a little bit different. I think we need to see some different things from the annual catalog that's going. So we're going to do something there with that. And then again, on Saturday at 10 o'clock, I do my my weekly sketch. Don't forget to enter your name or make a card and put this in. Like I say, Betty's already done it on this mystery challenge. And the nice thing about the mystery challenge is that you can go ahead and do it. So check out her card. She's done an amazing job there as well. And 10 o'clock on Saturday. In any event, you guys have a great rest of your day. And make sure that, like I say, give me the thumbs up and share it. I really do appreciate it. Bye for now. Don't forget to take the time to create, because it is so great for the soul. Bye for now.